Good morning, students. In the previous lecture, we have studied about the potentiometer. Just an introduction about the potentiometer. As I have said you that potentiometer has multiple uses, means it is used for comparing the EMF of the cell. It is also used for comparing the internal resistance of the cell. Many applications it has. But in our syllabus, only two applications are there. First one is to compare the EMF of the cell. Secondly, to find out the internal resistance of a cell. So let us, we'll start with the first one, to compare the EMF of a cell. So as we have seen that uniform wires are fitted on the wooden board, and these wires at one end A and one end B, this circuit is said to be the auxiliary circuit or the primary circuit. This is the key rheostat. It is used to change the values of the current. If the current is changing, we will keep the constant current with the help of the rheostat. This cell is said to be the driver cell, which drives the charge in the circuit. Okay. Now, first we will learn that is the comparison of EMF of a cell. Okay, comparison of EMF of a cell. For that, what we have to do, we will take two cells. We will take two cells and we will connect the positive end. See here, positive end of the driver cell, positive end of this cell whose EMF is E1, this cell to be the EMF E2, we will connect all the positive terminals at one fixed point. Okay, this is the another end of the wire. Let it suppose be one, let it suppose be two, and this be the galvanometer, this terminal be three, through a two-way key. We will attach this one through a two-way key. Okay, now the galvanometer is connected with a jockey. Okay, so now what we will do, we will start the experiment. We will connect these terminals 1 and 3. As we have made the circuit, so this cell first. Remember, the positive terminal of all the three cells are connected at the point A. So here we will join the connections 1 and 3. So what we will find that the current will flow in the circuit. The current will flow in the circuit, and with the help of the jockey, as I have told you that we should not rub jockey on the wire, we will just have a contact and to find out the null point. We will start from the initial length and then we will search in the potentiometer to find out the null point. Okay, so suppose at this point the galvanometer shows no deflection. No deflection means as the driver cell is sending out the current, so in this arm A, P1, and let's suppose this point be P. A, P1, P. In this arm there is no current. The galvanometer is not showing any deflection. Okay, that means what we will say, that no current is flowing in this arm. That is why the galvanometer, it is not showing any deflection. So can we say that the potential difference of this cell has become equal to the potential difference of this cell? At the point A, it has the same positive potential, and this cell also has the same positive potential. At the point P, see here, the potential of the point P is same as the potential of this one negative portion of the cell. Okay? So that means as no current is flowing, so potential difference of this driver cell is equal to the potential difference of these two points A and P. That is why no current is flowing in the cell. So can we write potential difference AP is equal to I rho L upon L1. Suppose this length comes out to be L1. Then how we will measure the length L? See, here we will start from the here. So suppose this length comes out to be 1 meter. As I have told you, it consists of four wires. That means it is a 4 wire potentiometer, so its length comes out to be 1 meter. Again we will look from here to here and we will see this here the reading. As I have told you, this scale consists of reading from 0 to 100 and again from 0 to 100. So we will start from here. Suppose this comes out to be 1 and it comes out to be the 20 centimeter. So total length will become 1 meter 20 centimeter or 30 centimeter in this way. You will note the length. Okay. So potential difference between A and B is equal to I rho L1 upon A. So can we say this is the EMF of the cell? Because as no current is flowing in the cell, so its potential differences becomes equal to the EMF of the cell to be compared. Now secondly, what we will do? We will make this connection out, okay, and we will join 2 and 3. So again we have to find out the null point in the wire. Again we will find out the null point in the wire, and suppose this comes out to be here. So what we will write? The potential difference. Now the new point A and Q that comes out to be I rho L2 upon A. And as we will finding out the null point, we will observe that here no current is flowing, that is why the galvanometer is not showing any deflection. So again we will measure this length, and this length comes out to be L2. Again, can we say that potential difference across AQ that is equal to the EMF of the cell? See, because here the no current is flowing, here there is no current. So what will happen? All the current is flowing in this direction. So the potential difference of AQ becomes equal to the potential difference of the driver cell. So here this is equal to this much. So when we will divide E1 upon E2, it comes out to be L1 upon L2. In this way, the EMF of a cell is compared. So here you should know that always that EMF of the driver cell should be greater than EMF of the cell to be compared, because if it has lesser EMF, then null point will not be obtained on the potentiometer wire. Secondly, one question is asked in the exam that if we can we interchange the positions at the null point, can we interchange the positions of the driver cell and the EMF? No, this cannot be done. As I have told you that EMF of the driver cell should always be greater than the EMF of the cell to be compared. So this cannot be done. Okay. So how EMF is compared with the length? E1 upon E2 is equal to L1 upon L2. Next.